Now, the News 8 Storm Team forecast with Dr. John Scala.
It's a hot one out there. Here's a live shot from our Harrisburg Skycam, and this has been the case for the last several days. Already 88 degrees coming in at Harrisburg International Airport. Temperatures across the rest of the region, very close to 90 degrees. Look at Thomasville coming in at 90 already. Gettysburg at 91, as is Chambersburg. Yeah, the cooler spot, Sealands Grove, 86 degrees. So very warm across the region. This will be the case as we move through the afternoon hours. The reason we're still looking at the remnants of high pressure, which extends from the southwest to the northeast right through the mid-Atlantic. To the south, Hurricane Earl making its approach towards Cape Hatteras. I'll talk more about that in just a minute. We've got a frontal system off towards the north and an area of showers and some embedded thunderstorms moving through the Midwest. It's behind that to the west that a cold front will finally bring an end to the heat that we have had for the last several days. But for this afternoon, 94 to 96 for most of us under hazy sunshine, maybe a couple of afternoon clouds. Tonight, a little bit more mild, up near 70 degrees for most of us, maybe even some of that river and valley fog again. Look for clear to partly cloudy skies, the high clouds associated with Earl. And as we move through the afternoon hours, this is going to be a hot one again. With Earl just off towards the east, we get some sinking motion around Earl itself, and that will actually help to keep us partly to mostly sunny with some late day clouds, but another hot one near 90 degrees, and the winds will pick up out of the west 10 to 20 miles per hour. Here are the latest on tropical storm warnings and hurricane warnings across the coast. All of this, these are hurricane warnings in place that run all the way up towards the North Carolina-Virginia border. These are tropical storm warnings that run all the way up towards Sandy Hook, New Jersey. And as we look up into the New England, this is actually a hurricane warning again for coastal Massachusetts, Cape Cod, Martha's Vineyard, with the possibility of a landfall up and down East Maine as we head into early Saturday. Here are the current stats. 140 mile per hour sustained winds. This is still a category 4, but at this point it looks like it's maxed out in terms of its intensity. It's about 590 miles from Atlantic City and about 300 miles due south of Cape Hatteras. Here's the track that is expected. It is expected to remain off the coast with hurricane force winds very close to Cape Hatteras. Tropical storm force winds may in fact affect much of the eastern seaboard all the way up towards Massachusetts, where once again, as we move into late Friday and early Saturday, the chance here for some hurricane force winds again near Cape Cod. And then it will finally make landfall as it moves up towards New Brunswick, Canada. Back towards closer to home, clear skies and light winds will make for a very hot day again today, with maybe a little bit of high cloudiness associated with Earl as it scoots up towards Cape Hatteras. As we move overnight and into Friday, again, mostly sunny skies, the closest approach of Earl by Friday morning, bringing some strong winds and heavy surf and potentially some damaging wind to the East Coast. That slides up towards New England, and we're looking at partly sunny skies later in the day. The frontal system coming towards us may bring us a light shower as we head early Saturday morning. But for the most part, this is going to be a dry frontal passage, and our temperatures will finally take a nosedive back into the 70s, but with some wind on the weekend.
Looking forward to the cooler temperatures.
And we will be watching Earl very closely.
Okay. It looks like a pretty powerful storm
very powerful
at this point.
Storm, yeah.
All right, John.